Chrissy, I love that you're back in Maine.
Yo, what up, though? Calling for Chrissy T.
Oh, it's Chrissy.
What's she going to say next?
Chrissy T in the morning, more like Chrissy Unfiltered in the morning.
Maine's new way to wake up. Chrissy in the morning on Portland's number one hit music station, Q97.9.
Yes, Chrissy, you're on the queue. Let's go. Woo!
Chrissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Here's a question. Here's a really good question. Have you ever accidentally had a Sunday Funday because it was above 50 degrees in Portland? Because same, if you saw me out in the Old Port yesterday, no you didn't. No you didn't. Shout out to Mashton. There's a bartender over there, Dan. He's fantastic. Everybody knows Dan. And then we went to Flatbread. The vibes were high at Flatbread. The bartender over there was also very sweet. I love a good bartender. I love a bartender that is just nice on a Sunday Funday. So here's what happened. Usually Sundays, I wake up, go to the gym, I get my grocery shopping done, and I do a little serotonin, a little menti health walk to TJ Maxx. Maybe the mall if I'm feeling feisty. And that's what I did yesterday. However, I didn't make it home. I wasn't tough enough to get back home without stopping at the bar. Now, Liquid Riot is closed on Sundays, and that's where I wanted to go. They were closed, didn't go there, just started walking around the Old Port. You ever done that before? You just start walking around the Old Port. You know it's there. You know exactly which little trinket is in which little store. You've seen it a million times driving by. But because it's over 50 degrees, it's different. It's different. And that's what happened. So I gave myself a curfew. And I got myself home by 7, which is great. But I realized this morning, you know, I feel like trash, of course. And boot camp later is going to be terrible. Got to get it done, though. I realized, I'm like, damn, I just had an accidental Sunday Funday. That was truly, truly, it was accidental. Do I have anybody listening right now that also had an accidental Sunday Funday just because the weather was above 20, 30, 40 degrees? Please call my phone line. Make it so that I'm
Chrissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Here's where I'm at with Apple TV. And I hope there's somebody listening right now who is just as obsessed with the show called The Morning Show. It's very ironic, I know. And I think that's why I resonate with it so well. It's got Jennifer Aniston in it. Can't remember the other guy's name who's from The Office. His name is Mitch, though, in the show. However, I just got so addicted, and Lori and I from HOM were just talking about it. It's a behind-the-scenes look at a newscasting station, okay? And not only just a newscasting station, it's a morning show station. Much like what we have going on here at Town Square Media. And I can relate to it so goddamn well. And here's the other thing is, I'm watching it yesterday, and Jennifer Aniston, who's one of my favorite actresses, she's absolutely gorgeous, so talented. They shot a scene where she moves to Maine. She moves to Maine. It's always so cool when you see your city, a small town city like that, be featured in such a big series, such a big television series. Now, if you do watch that show, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And I'm in the middle of actually writing an article. I'll tell you exactly where these guys actually ended up filming in Maine and how it came about. I looked it up. It's actually pretty interesting, which you can find that. It's trending right now on our Q97.9 app. Hit up WJBQ.com. But if you are a morning show watcher, there's 3 seasons so far. I'm only on season 1, so don't ruin it for me. Don't tell me what happens. I'm starting season 2 tonight. I have to carve out time for it because it's important. It's important. But call me right now if you are a morning show person on the morning show. Couldn't wait to make that pun. You know, it sounded funnier in my head before I said it out loud.
Chrissy in the morning on Q97.9.
You're on Chrissy in the morning, girlfriend. Tell me about your life. What's up? Good morning. Happy Monday.
So I'm a traveling CNA.
Ooh.
So I live in York, Maine, but I'm staying up in Waterville, Maine, so I can work at the veterans home.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah. So that's what I do. That's why I'm up right now.
I love that. Okay, so do we love our job or what's the deal? Because I feel like traveling nurses, you're only a travel nurse unless you love to travel.
So I do like my job. I was like staff for a while and then I went to agency and I absolutely love it. I do. You get to go to different places. You don't have to stay there. You can work a couple shifts and then leave, or you can just get contracted, which I'm contracted right now. So
gotcha.
But I absolutely love it.
So you have commitment issues is what you're telling me.
Yes. Yep. Absolutely.
Chrissy in the morning.
Hi, Chrissy in the morning. This is Donovan. If you learn from your mistakes, that's good. And if you don't, I don't know what to tell you, honestly.
Q97.9. We the best.
Here is the big question right now. I have a friend, and we were debating this yesterday. Yes, on my accidental Sunday fun day. I don't want to talk about it. But I'm a radio host, and I like talking to you and oversharing my life with you. Yeah, yesterday, if you were listening to the show a little bit earlier, I had an accidental Sunday fun day. I did. I don't usually drink on Sundays. I usually gym. I grocery shop. I get it together for the week. I'm sorry, but Portland was 55 degrees out yesterday, and I just wasn't tough enough, wasn't strong enough to make it home from the grocery store and not stop at the bar and see my friends. So I did. And when I went there, one of my friends was debating about this. She's been talking to this guy on Instagram, right? As we all do. As we all do. That's how everything starts nowadays. But he asked her out on a first date next Sunday. Is that weird? Oh, that's my phone. Next Sunday, he wants to go out. And in my head, I'm like, I feel like Friday nights are kind of a date night. Saturday nights are maybe a date night. You know, you can have a glass or a whole bottle of wine should you need to. But she asked me to ask you, Maine, our Q97.9 listeners, if it's weird that she asked or that he asked her out on a Sunday. Is Sunday a date day? I feel like it's a get your life together day. And I don't know. She thinks it's weird because her whole philosophy is, all right, he asked me out on a Sunday because he doesn't want to waste a Friday or a Saturday on another, you know, maybe he has another date with another girl and he doesn't really know how it's going to go with me. So he just chose to do a Sunday date day. And then I got to think of like, you know, I'm actually not sure about this one. Usually I feel like I have all the answers when it comes to boys, but this one I don't. Is a Sunday date day, the fact that he asked her out on a Sunday, is that weird? Dinner on a Sunday. Now that I think about it, I don't think I've ever had a Sunday date unless it was somebody that I was like a boyfriend. So 775-7979, real quick, Maine. I told her I would do this for her. A Sunday date night for a first date. Is that weird? Does that mean that he's already uninterested? He's got other things lined up. He doesn't want to waste a weekend. I don't know. Told her I would flip it to you. I'm going to hit a caller right here. Q97.9, you are live on Chrissy in the Morning. How are you?
I'm good. How you doing?
Good. Who's this?
It's Joe.
All right, Joe, don't swear. You're on the radio, okay?
Okay.
All righty, what do you think?
I think he might have work overnight, and he works Friday and Saturday night, so the Sunday's his only first day off.
Ooh, that's a good assumption. That sounds very specific, as if that's happened to you.
Yes. Okay. I work overnights, and I do the same thing.
All right, so we're sticking up for the guy.
Yep.
All right, I guess I get it, but I feel like he would have said that to her. Hey, I work Friday, Saturday. Or maybe they just haven't gotten that far yet. I don't know.
Maybe they haven't gotten that far.
All right, so one tally for it's not that weird. Fine. I'll give it to you. When we go on commercial right here, when we come back, I'm going to take some more tallies, okay? You're number one. You're my first tally for thinking it's not weird.
Okay.
Okay, fine. He's like, please, Chrissy, let me go. 775-7979. Phone lines are open. Let's do this. It is a Sunday date.
Chrissy in the Morning.
Hi, Chrissy in the Morning. This is Donovan. If you learn from your mistakes, that's good. And if you don't, I don't know what to tell you, honestly.
Q97.9. We the best.
Maine, you're pretty divided on this one. You're pretty divided. I didn't think he was going to pop off the way it did, but here we go. And if you are just tuning in, welcome to Chrissy in the Morning. We are back again trying to figure out my friend's love life. It's my favorite thing to do. It's my favorite thing to do with you. Now, this man has asked her out on a first date on a Sunday. He wants to go out to dinner this Sunday. And I'm calling a red flag immediately. I'm calling a red flag on the play. Nobody asks you out on a first date on a Sunday. You just don't do it. I don't want to have a glass of wine with a new guy on a Sunday. Because what if I have another glass of wine? I can't be trusted to stop. I'm just kidding. That's not the only reason. But let's be honest here. That's what happens. But Sunday just feels like, all right, you've got some plans with another girl going on a Friday and a Saturday. You can't lock me in. So you're just kind of giving me the throwaway shift. You're giving her the throwaway shift. Sunday is a throwaway shift for a date. I'm sorry, but I said what I said. What do you think? Q97.9, talk to me. Hello.
Hey, I don't think the day really matters.
Okay, why?
You said they met online.
Yep.
So on Instagram. You never know when you meet somebody online. He might have been chopping up and getting rid of the Saturday night date. Who knows?
That's what I'm saying, though, and that's where it's sketchy. I don't want that for her.
Yeah, it's kind of sketchy, but...
Because to me, it sounds like if you don't go out on a Friday or a Saturday and you can't, you know, etch someone in and pencil them in on Friday or Saturday,
either
you've got
that,
something else going on.
Either that or...
Oh, boy.
He figures that she has a job and it would be easier not to ask her to spend the night.
Well,
you gotta go home. I gotta get up and go to work.
Spending the night.
We move fast around here.
You're like, I'm not asking for a date. I'm asking for a sleepover.
But you want to feel it out first, you know? And
yeah,
then maybe
yeah.
The next one's a Friday for the weekend.
Okay, so Sunday is like a safe bet in your eyes.
Yeah, it's easy to get rid of them on a Sunday, you know?
Oh my God, goodbye. You're just as bad.
Bye bye.
Oh, baby. You naughty little biscotti. Why don't you just
meet me in the middle? Chrissy in the Morning on Q97.9.
All right. We're a little divided here, Maine. We're a little divided on this one. Let me catch you up to date. No pun intended. So my friend has been talking to this guy on Instagram for about a week. And just this weekend, he asked her to go out on a first date next Sunday. So this following Sunday, I'm sorry, but I called a red flag on the play. I did. I said red flag right here, right now. Maybe yellow. I don't know yet. Little yellow, little red. Because if you want to go out with somebody, lock in a Friday, commit to that Friday, commit to a Friday or Saturday. Because to me, a Sunday just sounds like you're not committed yet. And you're like, yeah, you know what? If it goes good, it's fine. If it doesn't go good, then it's fine. It's a Sunday. Right off the rip. To me, that sounds like he's just not capable of commitment. I don't know. I'm sorry. I said it. Hello.
What do I think? I think that it would trigger some questions, and I would have asked him some questions on why Sunday. But it's not really that odd. 90% of the Americans have Saturday, Sunday off. So why not have a date on Sunday?
Okay. See, I like the way you're looking at it. For me, I'm like, well, it's a school night for me. Monday is a work day. I'm feeling a little bit of stress. I don't want to go out on a date on a Sunday night. But to you, it doesn't make a difference, huh?
I mean, what are you doing? Going out to dinner? You're going to eat dinner anyway. Going out to a club and getting drunk? That's different. I mean,
you're
going
like,
to
hey,
a movie?
You got
to
eat
going
on a Sunday.
Going to a movie that could be 5, 6, 7 p.m.? That's still something that you would normally do anyway.
All right.
Maybe
all
not
right.
You because you got, you know, work at so early in the morning. But
my God, I feel like we're fighting right now. I love it. Q97.9, hello.
Hi, this is Eric. How are you?
What's up, Eric? I'm good.
Good. Well, I'm calling with some maybe some good news about the Sunday day date idea.
Okay, give it to me.
Well, my first date with my fiance was a Sunday day date. And
we're
2 years into it now, and we're engaged to be married.
Okay, so maybe this is the secret. Maybe this is the secret, and I got to switch the gears here because I'm thinking that Sunday dates are weird, right? Ask me out on a Friday night. But for you, you're like, no, I'm about to get married.
Yeah, for real. And if you think about it, you know, on a Sunday, you have all this time to spend with your partner during the day, and then if things go well, you still have the evening as well. So, you know, a Saturday night, you're sort of limited on time, and a Sunday, you literally have 12 hours if you want it, you know?
It's all about perspective, man. It's all about perspective.
We made a whole day out of it. We went to Boston and went to the aquarium and went on a cruise, you know, like a harbor cruise. We had a whole day. It was awesome.
Oh, my God. I'm tired just hearing that.
So anyway, best of luck to your friend. I think that it's going to go well.
Portland's number one hit music station, Q97.9. Chrissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Q97.9, what are you allergic to?
Oh, my God, it's not me, it's my daughter.
Oh, what is it? I feel like there's a list.
She's allergic to the cold.
Well, yeah, me too, girl, me too.
Like EpiPen, allergic to the cold.
Oh, okay, wait a minute. Now this is a different deal. Are you serious?
I swear to God.
How do you be allergic to the cold? What does that mean? What does that mean? How are you still living here?
Yeah, I know. Like, if she were to fall in the cold water or go into really, really cold snow, she'll go into anaphylaxis.
Oh, my God. I've never heard anything like that. And I'm so sorry. I don't mean to be insensitive.
Crazy.
I thought you were kidding.
No, swear to God.
Okay.
She actually really is allergic to the cold.
Okay, so when she walks outside on a normal day, when you are walking outside to go to your car and it's freezing, what happens?
Yeah. Bundle her up.
Okay, so she just can't... I have so many questions. So she just can't get overly freezing. So you always have to make sure she's got gloves on, a jacket.
Exactly. Yeah, everything. The whole nine yards.
An automatic car starter. I can't even believe you live in Maine. Why wouldn't you just go to Florida?
I would love to. Unfortunately, I co-parent with somebody that wants to stay in Maine. So.
And, well, don't they know that their daughter is allergic to the cold?
Oh, 100%. I know.
Wow. That's okay. You're winning right now. You are number one right now. God bless you and your daughter. Oh,
I know.
I am cold right
now. She's amazing. She's great. I'll do anything to, you know, protect her. And she's,
yeah, yeah.
You know, she's a girl after my own heart. That is for sure.
Now, imagine, I'm just picturing like her Tinder bio, like, I'm a great girl. I have a big heart, but I'm also allergic to the cold.
Exactly. I know. It's crazy. I never even knew.
I've never heard of anything like this.
Until we went to the allergist, and they were like, they put an ice cube on your wrist
to see
if you, she had all the allergy tests. She passed them all, and then finally they put an ice cube on her wrist, and she broke out in hives.
Weird. You would think that, okay. You would think that you would have already known that because I feel like that's a common thing to happen. She's like Elsa.
That was kind of, yeah, exactly.
Do you want to build a snowman?
Exactly.
Good luck with that.
You're the best, girl.
So are you, love.
Oh, baby.
You naughty little biscotti.
Q97.9. Chrissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Good morning. Who's this? Hello.
Hey, would you do me a favor and shout out the Central Maine Community College in Lewiston, Maine women's basketball? They won the national. They won their title.
Oh, absolutely! Yesterday. Hell yeah!
And, thanks. And everybody and like across New England was completely against these girls winning because they've won for like the last 7 years.
So they were the underdog.
Yeah. So they were. Everybody was just rooting for them to lose, but they pulled it off at the end.
Hell yeah.
And congratulations to them for 7 years straight for winning the title.
Oh, I love a good, powerful woman story, so hell yeah.
Thank you, guys. Have a good day.
Oh, baby.
You naughty little biscotti.
Why don't you just meet me in the middle? Chrissy in the morning on Q97.9.
You don't realize how long you can stretch this topic out until you ask the simple question of Maine, what are you allergic to? Hello.
Oh, my God, it's not me, it's my daughter.
Oh, what is it? I feel like there's a list.
She's allergic to the cold.
Well, yeah, me too, girl, me too.
Like EpiPen, allergic to the cold.
Oh, okay, wait a minute. Now this is a different deal. Are you serious?
I swear to God.
How do you be allergic to the cold? What does that mean? What does that mean? How are you still living here?
Yeah, I know. Like, if she were to fall in the cold water or go into really, really cold snow, she'll go into anaphylaxis.
Oh, my God. I've never heard anything like that. And I'm so sorry. I don't mean to be insensitive. Crazy. I thought you were kidding.
No, swear to God. Okay. She actually really is allergic to the cold.
Okay, so when she walks outside on a normal day, when you are walking outside to go to your car and it's freezing, what happens?
Yeah, bundle her up.
Okay, so she just can't, I have so many questions. So she just can't get overly freezing. So you always have to make sure she's got gloves on, a jacket.
Exactly, yeah, everything, the whole nine yards.
An automatic car starter. I can't even believe you live in Maine. Why wouldn't you just go to Florida?
I would love to. Unfortunately, I co-parent with somebody that wants to stay in Maine, so...
And, well, don't they know that their daughter is allergic to the cold?
Oh, 100%. I know.
Wow. That's okay. You're winning right now. You are number one right now. God bless you and your daughter. Oh.
I know. She's amazing. She's great. And I'll do anything to, you know, protect her. And she's,
You know,
she's a girl after my own heart. That is for sure.
Now, imagine, I'm just picturing like her Tinder bio, like, I'm a great girl, I have a big heart, but I'm also allergic to the cold.
Exactly. I know, it's crazy. I never even knew, like, until we went to the allergist and they were like, they put an ice cube on your wrist see if you, she had all the allergy tests. Finally they put an ice cube on her wrist and she broke out in hives.
You would think that you would have already known that, because I feel like that's a common thing to happen. She's like Elsa.
Exactly.
Do you want to build a snowman?
Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play.
Chrissy, you're the best girl. I love you, babe. Oh, baby.
You naughty little biscotti. Why don't you just
meet me in the middle? Chrissy in the morning on Q97.9.
All right. I got a question. It's all over the news. It's all over the internet. It's on your TikTok. It's on your Instagram. It's called Who TF Did I Marry? And the girl is probably the most famous woman in the world right now, besides Taylor Swift, who just won her first Super Bowl. But it's this girl that's going viral because in different parts of TikTok, she is uploading all of these stories about how her husband was cheating on her. And it's like part one, part two, part three, and they're all in different TikToks. And even my friends have fallen victim to it. They've, not to the cheating husband, but to watching all of these YouTubes pop up and TikToks pop up, and it's almost consuming their brain of what's going to happen next. And, you know, when's the next episode of this cheating guy? And she finally spoke out this morning. I'm not going to play it because there's a lot of swear words in it, and I'm sure that you've already seen it. But do I have anybody listening right now who is following this? And do you think it's real? Is this who the TF, I don't want to say because I don't like to swear. Kid show. Is there anybody following this that believes it? Is this really a thing? People can go viral on TikTok over anything. I swear. You know, what happened to hard work, man? What happened to hard work? I'm over here 15 years into my radio career trying to make it. And there's TikTok stars going viral overnight, making more money than I'll ever see. But who TF did I marry? Let's talk about that. 775-7979. Do I have anybody who is locked in, listening to every episode right now? She clearly is trying to hold a very big vendetta against her. Sorry, I'm scrolling through it right now. I'm trying to think and talk at the same time. But I think he spoke out too. But
Chrissy in the morning on Q97.9.